The Boston Celtics are the most storied franchise in the National Basketball Association. From 1957 to 1986, they won 16 championships, led by some of the greatest and most talented players the NBA has ever seen. Then the franchise had its ups and downs. That was until 2007 came around. Under the direction of Glenn Doc Rivers, their big three led a revitalization of hoops in Boston, returning them to the mountaintop from which they had not stood in over 20 years. For six seasons, the Celtics were a thorn in everyone's side, providing the toughest challenge every time they stepped on the court. It's a new era for Boston basketball. Garnett and Pierce were traded to Brooklyn. Doc is in Hollywood, trying to turn that city from purple and gold to red, white, and blue. Meanwhile, the Celtics have handed the keys to the most decorated franchise in the NBA to the youngest coach in the NBA. Together, they will slowly look to turn Boston Celtic basketball back to its glory days, one game at a time.
Windy Saturday night, the NBA stage is Miami. The two teams, no strangers, longtime rivals, and now heading down two very different roads, contention and rebuilding. That's right. Welcome, everybody, inside the American Airlines Arena. Tonight, the first of three between the Miami Heat and the Boston Celtics. And we always hope, as the Heat take the floor, that you enjoy every bounce and basket right along with us. Miami Heat basketball on Sun Sports, always presented by AT&T UVerse. And we say good evening to the Heat Nation. We hope you're enjoying a great weekend. And thank you, as always.
Drop the beat. Slice up the rhythm. Ginzu, shred it. Bang, spit venom. Go get it. Bang to the bank. Don't sweat it. In the veins where the blood bumps. It's synthetic. Roll like C4. Blast out the gates. Pedal to the floor if you got what it takes.
Gun to the basket. Lay up and in.
Got what it takes. That's what you came for. That's what you came for. Ain't it?
Baseline jump shot. Rattled it in.
You go get it. That's what you came for. What you came for.
The dancing way, the defending rim.
You don't get it. That's what you came for.
Drop the beat.
Stretch to try to keep the team close. He did so many positive things. 4 of 6 from the field. 2 rebounds, couple of assists. Got himself to the line. That was ridiculous. The strength there on the spin. Trying to foul him. Still can't stop LeBron. And look at this one. Anytime you're shooting a shot fading away, going away from the basket to your opposite hand, that's one of the hardest shots in basketball. You got it going, making that mid-range jumper there. And it's just not enough, though, unfortunately, Jax. The offense overall was incredibly balanced. You see the three all-stars, but they wind up getting 5 different guys in double figures. Check that, 6 different guys in double figures.
A good, which had been a part of the discussion of things they like to change early. Green, though, taking over my highlight, jamming some N1 basketball for your face. But LeBron James has a couple plays to help out as well. LeBron James hitting 5 of his 6 shots in the first half. That was one of them. And then reverse. I need to see this one more time. I need the Warrell Broadcasting System to give me a replay, and I got it. What back spasms? Mr. Bosch, you are efficient. Show me why. That is high percentage people. Then Mr. Bass getting into the jam fest. That stopped a 9-0 run there from the Miami Heat. And then LeBron, homage to Kareem. Little skyhook action right there. The Heat hit 8 of their first 11 field goals, up 23-14 early on. We talked to you about Mr. Crawford. Drawford. Jordan Crawford. That's what you get when you put Jordan Crawford together, is Drawford. He's 3 for 3. Boston was at that point from out there. Now the Birdman came in, hit 4 of 5 early in this game. On way to 10 points. The Heat shot 65% in the first quarter. To the second quarter, it's the Boston bench helping to roll. First Green with activity, then Wallace on the breakaway. Humphreys, yeah, little action to get him to the line right there. That is not the best defense. Tony will be by to let us know about that one right there. That was something else. Then banging, action, up and slamming. I told you the Boston reserves were doing some damage. So are the Heat reserves. That's a little flip action from Anderson, staying with it to get it done. And then Birdman. Hustle, See, the thing I love about Bird is that you'll get that right there, okay? And then I'm getting back to the bench.
Always spreading, always doing.
I need Courtney Lee in my highlight. I'm not sure why I needed it, but I anticipated it was coming. But let me tell you something. Something went down. Now, here's the thing. When a team sees an advantage for a player, just like you see right here with Michael Beasley, they scream sometimes, barbecue chicken. Well, B's got a whole bunch of it. And I know Crawford wanted to get in there for the buzzer three and try to make it look all awesome. But B's was phenomenal as he came off the bench on fire.
In the three-point area.
Yeah. Open, look, splash. He hit five of them from the land of milk and honey. Give me some Bosch. I need a layup, no-look action. There's some really actually some nice movements, some nice work.
Gorgeous. Dive and cuts and two-man gain. The Heat shared the ball very well again.
And Bosch going up for rejection on Wallace. Now, we got a little run going here for the Miami Heat. A 7-0 run, and Wade is helping out with a little turnaround. Timmy. Then Green again. Might want to guard this guy. He's just launching and doing.
He's 6'9", so it's hard to block that shot if you're not right up on him. LeBron giving him a little too much room there.
Wayne working hard, backing down, turning around. Jumper goes down. Then Bosch, a little and-one basketball right there. And here's some of that transition issue you were talking about, John. A little transition action for Bradley. And then Humphreys, hello. This is going the other way after that, too. That led to a Bradley layup. Two-point game. Wade, jumper. Oh, no, there's that layup I was talking about. Look at that. What am I doing? Why rush it? There's Dwayne. Schwackums. That ends the quarter. And the Heat up two to the fourth quarter. Seriously, I think Green only shot the second half. This fourth three-pointer out of the five that he made, you know, and the fifth one's coming up, and then a big block out of the little guy right there. My goodness. Norris Cole. Finding the only other guy that's shorter than him.
Wow, that was an impressive finish again by Green. That's what makes him so tough to guard. He can get to the rim off the dribble or step out beyond the three-point line and drill three, so you can't overplay him.
Time for the Cleveland Clinic team play of the game. LeBron with the layup, Bosch with a nice pass. I can see LeBron. With Elton.
Yeah, with the right-hand pass, too. Bosch showing great vision there.
Drop around. Action. Good one. I believe his only assist of the game. Now, give me that spin. He's spinning and spinning and spinning, and it's in. Oh, yeah. No, he gathered people. Gathered the rock, and this is a good basket.
Look at Crawford trying to wrap him up, and he can't stop the big fella. 6'8", 255 pounds of manhood right there with the finish.
102.95. Here comes Boston, Crotty. Bradley with the three. Heat now up 102.98. Then Bradley, little runner. Got ourselves a two-point game right here, 102-100. LeBron trying to create some space, a little jumper. Solid. Heat now up four. Now Crawford coming back. He's a point guard, but that man likes to shoot.
Yeah, he does.
It's a two-point game, 106-104. LeBron. LeBron. LeBron James, ninth point of the quarter. Now the little isolation does not go the way he wants it to go there.
Fading away, works to the Celtics' favor. They have a run out right off that miss.
And we got ourselves a two-point game because a man with a zero just got 2 points right there. Now, Wade gets the Bosch. That could have been your door closer right there, right off the front rim. Olenek, not exactly where he wants to be. LeBron going to get fouled here. Hits his free throws, 110-106. And Wallace, layup off the inbound. He would be the inbounder in just a bit, by the way. Now Wade, that's in free throws. We know all about this situation. There's the problem. Time now for the All My Sons play of the game. We know what's happening here. Wallace Green, good night. I thought it was a long count. I really did. I had 6.5 seconds right here. I got to the second set of S's in Mississippi after I counted.
Nice.
Doesn't matter what I think.
No, you're right. It doesn't, unfortunately.
No, Bill Spooner. Put an apple. It's an L, people. 111-110. That's the final. Nice job by Green. LeBron James nearly the triple-double. And it is a night where, goodness, man, he just kept rolling. 10 assists, 8 rebounds. Chris Bosch, 20 points and 7 rebounds. You saw that one assist. Had a couple blocks and a rip, and now a little time on television. 111 to 110. So close. No horseshoes today, though. Our next telecast comes your way Tuesday night when the Heat take on the visiting Milwaukee Bucks at 7:30. Heat Live, delivered by Papa John's, starts the night off at 7 o'clock right in this beautiful renovated studio. Johnny, you look great against the skyline, by the way.
Thank you.
I mean, just absolutely gorgeous. This has been a presentation of Sun Sports, your exclusive home for Miami Heat basketball. For E. Reed, the coach, KU, Friday, I'm Jax. Good night. Final take. Roll it.